Since Apple introduced the MacBook with M-series chips, Wi-Fi repair has become significantly more difficult. Wi-Fi and Bluetooth are now integrated into a single chip. Once this chip fails, the only option is to replace the entire motherboard. But now, a new solution has emerged. In this video, REWA will demonstrate how to repair the Wi-Fi issue on a MacBook Air by replacing the Wi-Fi chip. The Wi-Fi on this MacBook won't turn on. It has been diagnosed as a Wi-Fi chip failure. To repair this issue, we need to read the MacBook's serial number, also named exclusive chip ID, and unbind the Wi-Fi chip from the motherboard. Install the Luban software via flash drive. After launching the software, it requires internet connection. At this point, we'll use the hotspot from a phone. Connect the phone to the MacBook via USB. Trust this computer on the phone. Turn on hotspot on the phone. The Luban software automatically unbinds the Wi-Fi chip and reads the serial number, also called DCID. Open the MacBook setting to verify the serial number is correct. Power off the MacBook. Remove the lower case. Disconnect the battery. Remove the motherboard. Unscrew the mounting screws, and remove the heatsink. Next, we need to remove the Wi-Fi chip. Secure the motherboard in place using a fixture. Use a hot air gun to soften the adhesive around the Wi-Fi chip, and gently remove the adhesive with tweezers. Do not apply heat directly to the chip at this stage. Move the hot air gun clockwise above the chip to apply even heat. Insert a pry and gently lift up the chip. Apply flux and medium temp solder to neutralize the high temp solder on the pads. This reduces the heat needed when soldering the new chip and lowers the risk of damage. Heat around the pads and remove black adhesive with a scraper. Then clean the old solder and adhesive on the pads. Clean the pads with PCB cleaner. Apply flux again and use Solder Wick to fully clean the solder pads. Wipe the pads with cotton dampened with PCB cleaner again. Install the MacBook Wi-Fi repair module to the programmer. Connect the programmer to a computer that runs the Luban tool software. Place the new Wi-Fi chip in the repair module. Open the Luban tool software and wait for it to read the Wi-Fi chip. Input the ECID that has been read earlier. Click Check Now. The field below is automatically filled up. Click Write Server Data. Verify the info is correct. Tick the confirmation and click Confirm Write. Wait for the write to finish. The write is successful when the result reads Pass. Disconnect the programmer from the computer. Remove the Wi-Fi chip from the module. Align a solder stencil with the chip solder pads. Spread mid-temp solder paste evenly over the stencil. Use a hot air gun to reflow the solder. Apply flux to the solder pads of the chip. Heat the solder pads with a hot air gun to even out the solder joints. Apply flux to the solder pads on the motherboard. Align the Wi-Fi chip with the solder pads with tweezers. Move the hot air gun clockwise above the chip to apply even heat. Tap the chip with tweezers to check if it's securely soldered. The reflow is easier since we use mid-temp solder. Use a fan to cool the chip down quickly. Test the capacitors around the Wi-Fi chip with a multimeter. The reading is normal. Reinstall the heatsink module. Reinstall the motherboard. Reconnect the battery cable. Install the lower case. Since the battery cable was disconnected, we need to plug in the charger to activate the battery and power on the MacBook. The Wi-Fi is now working properly. Open settings to check the EC ID. It remains the same. Thank you for watching.